from the great state of New Jersey, Senator Bob Menendez. Let's hear it. My friends, we stand here united in support of something that cannot wait any longer. We stand here today to say that we want something that not only saves our budget, but saves our lives. We're here for something that shouldn't be considered a privilege, but should be a right in the greatest country on the face of the earth. And that's quality, affordable health care for each and every American. And what does that mean to me? That means that every American gets health care. That means that those who have health care get to keep it, and they don't get denied simply because an insurance company wants to deny them from critical health care. It means that we need a public option for real competition in this health care system. And it means that the benefits that you have worked for and organized labor has worked for needs to be preserved as part of that overall mandate. People are asking themselves, is it fair that a family member or a neighbor with disease can't get coverage? Does it make sense that I lose my health insurance if I lose my job or change jobs in this recession? And then we wind up one health crisis away from bankruptcy. Does it make any economic sense that even with the lack of options, my costs keep going up and up? In this great nation of ours, no one should go to sleep in America without health care coverage. No one should have to choose between paying for their medicine and having access to the opportunity for the health care that they need. No one should have to have an illness and have had that illness at one point in their life and then be denied health care coverage as a result of it. And no one should fear that the next medical treatment is going to put them into bankruptcy. We can do better. We must do better. And that means comprehensive health care for each and every American. Finally, in the greatest country in the world, can we honestly look at our brothers and sisters and say that 50 million of you have to worry every night that you cannot afford to get ill because you do not have the ability to have health care coverage? Do we have to, in the greatest country in the world, even for those who have insurance, constantly hear from insurance companies, no, even when you do everything right? This can be and must be better, and that's why the old saying, there is nothing more powerful on earth than an idea whose time has come. And this idea and this time has come now. And together in the Senate and in the Congress, working with President Obama, we will get health care for each and every American. Si se puede. Si se puede. Yes, we can. Yes, we can.
Sisters and brothers, my name is Jerry McEntee, and I am proud to stand here and represent the 1,600,000 members of AFSCME, the workers who make America happen. Sisters and brothers, we are here today because we have to fight to win the reform this country needs. And remember, sisters and brothers, right behind me, that's the Capitol of the United States. Now there are senators there are House members there are all kinds of committees meeting, but let me tell you, and please believe it, that is your Capitol. It belongs to you, the people of this country, that's who it belongs to. Let it be known that our opponents will fight hard. They'll fight dirty. They'll outspend us. Remember last time we tried to do health care and they had Harry and Louise And Harry and Louise were all over television telling everybody how bad universal health care would be. And we never got it, and they never got it, Harry and Louise. Harry's dead, and Louise has diabetes. Rush Limbaugh, Rick Scott, the insurance companies. It's all right, boo, boo, come on. They don't want to fix health care. They want to scare people. They talk about what? Socialized medicine? Big government. Countries like Great Britain. Not us. We're talking about affordable health care for all. Lower cost. More choice. We're not talking about other countries. We're talking about America, an American solution for all of everybody in this country. A lot of people say we can't afford to fix health care now. The president has made it clear we can't afford not to. There's a right way and a wrong way to pay for this. The wrong way is to tax health care benefits. That was John McCain's idea. Look where it got him. Yeah, look where it got him. It will hurt working families. And listen to me on this one. It will turn good people against great reform. That's why Limbaugh and his right-wing friends want to see Congress tax our health benefits. And they have been earned by you at the collective bargaining table, giving up wage increases, giving up vacation days, in order to get health care for you and your family, and nobody's going to take it away from us. They want to divide us, worker against worker, but they can't. Because look at this. We are united to win. Now, let me mention the right way. Start by taxing the very wealthy. Very wealthy. Anybody in here make $300,000 a year? Anybody? I didn't think. So we start by taxing the very wealthy who got one tax break after another under George Bush. He's still hiding, George. Cheney's not hiding, but he's still not making any damn sense. We got to close corporate tax loopholes. We got to increase preventive care. Stop unnecessary procedures. That's right, there I go. Ask everyone to share the responsibility for this. This is our year. What do we want?
Healthcare!
When do we want it?
Now!
Thank you, and God bless America, and God bless you.